It's a spectrum NASCAR. He doesn't mention, you know. So anyway, just kind of interesting how they translate those three words. And put that in the video. But he had a really good, for me, his comprehension. They're interesting. I like science fiction. Also read Dune by Frank Herbert. Read the Russian translation of that. And it was kind of neat because you have Duke Leto and Atreides, Baron Harkonnen. And, you know, just kind of interesting. Like a technical book, physics, or something like that. Very, you kind of dry. Translation is sort of cut and dry, black and white. Would require more concentration. So yeah, I'm looking at the Star Roper here. Page 222 is talking about Odysseus, Uranus, the legate of Syria. And a character named Rodbrog, which is so interesting. Okay, the character in the Star Roper, Rodbrog, is talking about Niflheim, Muspel, the birth of the giant Ymir, from the snowflakes of the Tau, and Homba. And Homba. Okay. And I don't know if I've heard of Homba before. And Homba. And the Fenrir. And Loki. And the frozen Jotuns. As I say, when I told her all this, and the Thor and Odin, and our own Valhalla, she clapped her hands and cried out with sparkling eyes, "Oh, you barbarian, you great child, you yellow giant thing of the frost, you believer of old Norse tales and stomach satisfactions, but the spirit of you, that which cannot die, where will it go when your body is dead? As I have said, Valhalla," I answered, "and my body shall be there for you, eating, drinking, fighting." She questions, okay, which one? "And loving," I added. "We must have our women in heaven. Else what is heaven for?" "I do not like your heaven," she said. "It is a bad place, a beast place, a place of frost and storms and fury." So that's on page 225 of the Star Roper by Jack Martin, published in 1915. So I'd be interested to see, like, how is that passage translated into Russian? Because you have concepts in here, Niflheim, Muspel, Ymir, Akhobla, the Jotuns, Valhalla. And so is that Old English? Is it Saxon? Is it like Old Norse or Nordic, or and part of the English language? Or is this like something that got borrowed from Denmark or Norway or Sweden, and then did Russia borrow it, you know? Or is this just, you know, what would the translation be? Like, is this totally, this is like, well, this is a Swedish word? Or is it like the same word, English, the same word in Russian, the same. So I just have to see how to translate, how the translator did it. And I want to learn historical linguistics and the rules of sound change. And we have, I think it's, I don't know if it's Boolean algebra or regular algebra, but we have like A is greater than B. So A is like Old Norse. Old Norse is greater than Middle English. Like Old Norse is equal to Icelandic. Have I lived through and died in, my reader, only that I remember them, you do not. Okay. So that's on page 298. That's pretty cool. So, start over. That's a pretty beat up copy. I'm going to get my Russian copy, and I have another copy. I have another book here. It's got my name on it. This is one I bought in Cambridge, Massachusetts, a while ago. By the Star Company. That's that. I got two copies of that.